What up, peeps? It's your girl, Dutch, coming back to you for Old Takes. Well, it looks like a trailer has dropped for Queen and Slim. More like a first look. I'm curious to see what this is about. I had heard Daniel Kaluuya was working on this. Wasn't sure when it would be dropping. It was going to be later this summer. I think this is considered a fall release. So I'm actually excited. I'm glad I didn't catch it during the BET Awards because I kept flipping between this and another show. So you know what? Let's go ahead and jump into it. And I'll say the rest of my thoughts at the end, you guys.
What made you pick me?
I liked your picture.
What?
You have this sad look on your face. I felt sorry for you.
Oh, wow.
So what happened tonight?
Did you think we were going to have sex?
Nah. No. I thought we were going to hang out. Maybe get to know each other.
Well, wait, okay.
You're swerving a little bit back there. Go ahead and ask you to step out of the vehicle for me.
Millennium.
Are you serious?
Why is he under
arrest? Just chill, just chill. Get back in the car, you're going to jail too.
Wow, okay. What do you want?
Want to ride or die?
Cop killers! Cop killers!
It was self-defense.
There is nothing back there for us.
That's an interesting choice of music for this particular.
I ain't gonna bend the world. As long as my lady remembers me fondly, that's all I need.
Can I be your legacy?
You already are.
All right, you guys, I really enjoyed this trailer. This is definitely going to be on my radar to watch when this comes out. I don't think I saw when it says it does come out. I want to think sometime later this fall. I like the overall way that the story's being done. You would almost feel like you're getting a vibe of Bonnie and Clyde, like they're on a run now in certain terms in regards to how things, you know, transpired with that particular situation that happened that went totally awry. I like how it's set up where they look like they're on a first date, whatever, they're finally just meeting, and she's saying she liked his face, you know, he has sad eyes, you know, she felt sorry for him, like, wow. And I love Daniel's response to that. That was hilarious. But of course, you see it takes a certain turn. We see the situation where, you know, of course the cop says he pulls him over because they were kind of swerving. You know, I'm like, okay. Now, granted, I want to think because he keeps staring at her in the car, talking to her, and I focus on the road, that scenario could be true. Everything after that, we don't see all the parts to see exactly what could possibly happen for him, you know, to, you know, get the one up on him enough, whatever, knock him down, whatever, and all, and they kind of have a tussle, and he ends up with the gun, and he shoots him. You know, so that's going to be interesting to see how it climaxed to that scene, to see where they got to this point where now they're on the run. I want to see who else, you know, they're going to be coming in contact. We already saw it says Chloe, 7A's in this, love her. And I saw Bokeem Woodbine, I'm a fan of him immensely. So I'm excited to see him. Always love seeing him and stuff. I'm curious what would definitely be the outcome. You know, not to say, you know, they might eventually get caught or whatever, but it looks like they're on their own. They're changing up, you know, her hair. She's, you know, cut the braids off. You know, he's cutting his hair off. They're trying to stay on the low, you know, just traveling. Of course, you see her very, you know, kind of upset because it's a lot prior to take because she can't go back to whatever normalcy she had because they are on the run. The choice of music I thought was really interesting, the Staying Alive. I'm going to take the Bee Gees music. I'm like, okay, I love me some Bee Gees. Also, you know, Can't Get Away. Yeah, I'm going to really have to check out that soundtrack too when this comes out because it sounds like it's going to be really good. I love how it's all over, you know, in regards to the different, you know, music genres. So, and then I see it says screenplay written by, you know, Lena Waithe. Love her. And then also introducing a new director. I think her name was Melina Masuka. I hope I'm saying it correctly. My apologies. So loving what I'm seeing from, you know, her directorial debut. So I'm excited about that. I will say this because I'm going to go ahead and cut this short after this. I feel like a lot of individuals will have something to say about this. You know, some people, oh, you know, I just feel like they're doing another movie that's like this. And I go, I'm going to put it like this. I watch all types of movies, white, black, whatever. I see movies like this where white people play it. And I have no problem watching movies like this when black people play it. that is just what it is. It is, you know, it's a movie, but then it's giving you certain realisms and undertones, whichever, but then certain parts that are not, you know, reality. Of course, them being on a run, being gone for so, you know, certain things that it probably would not actually happen. So you're getting a little bit of, you know, reality with reality. And it is what it is. I have no problem watching this things because I'm like this. I watch a lot of different types of movies that are put out, you know, that try to showcase African-Americans, you know, in a good light, so to speak, whichever. You have other movies like, you know, What Men Want, What This, Whatever, and then you have this. Then you have other movies that you see that might be in the theaters, might be on cable, might be Netflix, whatever, and all that. Some people might like, oh, it looks cheesy. Then you see this, oh, they're doing this. You can't win for losing with some individuals, but that's fine. They can just sit over there and they can keep ranting and raving about it, whichever. And while they're not watching it, I will be watching this because I want to see this. I'm not going to use this movie to depict thinking this is all that you see of African-American communities that are showing for representation. It's not. And if you're a movie buff, you can understand that and take it for what it is. Either you want to see it or you don't. You don't, then you got nothing to worry about. It is what it is. Keep it moving. So, you know, people got to go out here, and then, you know, you have, you know, sisters out here, you know, directing movies, whichever, who barely get to direct them. You know what? Support. You know, that's the whole thing right there as well. We don't have enough of them out here doing this diversity in, you know, behind the scenes, in front of the camera, behind the camera. And then when you finally get it, you know, individuals don't want to support. Well, you go ahead and see how that works, because that doesn't work that way. You know, you want what you want, but then when you get it, you don't like what you're getting in regards to the overall outcome or whatever they're giving you to depict. You're going to get movies of all categories, genres, whichever, and all that. Some of you won't like it, some of you don't. It's up to you to choose. You're going to support it or not. Don't, then there you go. Don't waste any more energy and stress and rant and raving about it, whatever, and all that. All you're doing is making it more issue for yourself, because everybody else who wants to see it is going to go see it. So, but needless to say, I had to get that off here, because it's just comical, some of the things that you can read in comment sections when people start going off, you know, giving themselves, you know, all this anxiety, complaining, as if their complaint is going to make it stop. It's not going to stop. Individuals are putting movies out like certain things like this and other things, whichever, you know, to show their craft, show, you know, other things, you know, make you think. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. I embrace it. It is what it is. And I'm here for the ride. Like he is. He got his ride or die. I'm going to be right there to watch them ride or die out there in the sunset. So, but with that said, comment below. Let me know what you all think of the trailer. And with that said, I will see you guys on the next reaction. You guys take care.